Good morning, students. This is PSV Shanmukhi. I'd like to give a brief talk on motion of an object which is moving in a straight line under uniform acceleration. See, in this topic, first of all, let us derive or let us discuss the derivation of equations of motion using calculation method. Equations of motion derivation we have to discuss. Actually, in the previous classes, you must have studied the equations of motion. But here, we have to derive those equations. As an essay question, this will be asked in the exams. Actually, what are the equations of motion you have studied? See, coming to first equation of motion. The first one, equation of motion, say V is equal to U plus AT. V is equal to U plus AT. Okay. Second one, S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Third one, V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. So, there are four equations. Fourth one, Sn is equal to u plus a by t into 2n minus 1. That equation also there. Four equations are there. Here, we have to discuss or we have to derive these equations by using the calculus method. What is the first equation we are taking? The first equation, see, v is equal to u plus at. V is equal to U plus AT. What is U? Initial velocity U. What is V? Final velocity. Say that is V. If the initial velocity is known, acceleration times are known, we can determine the final velocity of the body. Or else, if the final velocity is given, and initial velocity is also given, you can also determine the acceleration. This is the first equation. What is the second equation? The second equation, V square minus U square is equal to S. S is equal to, what is the second one? UT plus half AT square. UT plus half AT square. Say, what is the third equation? The third equation. See, third one. V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. See, V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. See, these three equations we have to derive by using the calculus method. First one, V is equal to U plus AT. Second, S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Third one, V square minus U square is equal to S. So, using these equations, first of all, what is the use? What is the use of these equations? If the initial conditions are given, now, if the initial velocity is given, we can determine the final velocity. If the initial velocity, final velocities are given, we can determine the acceleration or as a displacement. All these things we can determine. So, we discuss these things at the time of applications of these equations. Here, first of all, we have to discuss how to derive these equations using the calculus method. Coming to the first one, what is the acceleration definition? Acceleration is nothing but rate of change of velocity. Rate of change of velocity means change in the velocity over time. Or A is equal to dv by dt. A is equal to dv by dt. See, here acceleration A is equal to dv by dt. Of course, I want to write dv is equal to A into dt. Suppose integrate on both sides. Doing the integration, definite integrals, integral dv is equal to A integral A into integral dt. What are the integration limits? Coming to velocity, initial velocity is u, final velocity v. What is the initial time, starting time? The moment the body starts moving, zero time. And the final time, it is t. So integral dv, what is integral dv? We get v. So integral dv means we get v. What are the limits? V to minus v minus u, we have to write. V minus u is equal to A into t minus 0. So what do you get here? V is equal to u plus at. Here we are getting the first equation of motion, v is equal to u plus at. How we are getting? Just taking the acceleration, rate of change of velocity dv by dt, writing dv is equal to A into dt, integrating on both sides, we get v is equal to u plus at. Here dv means v minus u is equal to A into t, we get v is equal to u plus at. This is the first equation of motion. Coming to the second one. See, what is the second equation? S is equal to ut plus half at square. To derive this one, just take the velocity definition. What is the velocity definition? Rate of change of displacement. Velocity, rate of change of displacement. ds by dt. So, v is equal to ds by dt. Therefore, ds is equal to what we get? V into dt. So, what is v? First equation already we derived. V is equal to u plus at. Therefore, u dt plus at into dt. Now, integrate on both sides. By integrating on both sides, what we get? Integral ds is equal to u dt plus a into integral t dt. Actually here a is constant. Why? Under uniform acceleration we are discussing a is constant, acceleration is constant, whereas displacement is a variable, time is a variable, and velocity, it is also a variable. Okay, final velocity means that final velocity is a variable. So initial velocity, say it is u constant. Integral ds means what we get? S. What are the limits? 0 to s. What are the limits for time? 0 to t. 0 and this is t. Therefore, integral ds means s we get. Integral dt, t. Therefore, what we get? Ut plus a into what is the integration of t dt? Integral x dx means x square by 2. Integral t dt means t square by 2. Therefore, we get ut plus a into t square by 2. Therefore, ut plus half a t square. What is the second equation of motion? S is equal to ut plus half a t square. This is the second equation of motion. What is the third equation of motion? V square minus u square is equal to 2as. For this, simply let us do one thing. Write the definition of acceleration. What is acceleration once again? Rate of change of velocity. Rate of change of velocity, A is equal to dv by dt. So A is equal to dv by dt I am writing. But here what I am doing? Multiplying with ds and dividing with ds. Multiplying and dividing with ds. What we get? Dv by ds into ds by dt. What is this ds by dt? ds by dt rate of change of displacement means velocity. It is the velocity. Therefore, A is equal to dv by ds into v. So I want to write A into ds. Write this ds in the left hand side. A into ds is equal to v dv. Therefore, again integrating on both sides, what do we get? A into integral ds is equal to v integral v dv. What is this integral ds? We get s only. A into s. What is v dv? Just like x into dx. Integral x into dx is x square by 2. Like that, integral v into dv, v square by 2. What are the limits? Lower limit is u, upper limit is v. Initial velocity u, final velocity v. Therefore, substitute this u and v. What we get? V square by 2 minus u square by 2, RHS we get. This 2 right in the left hand side. Therefore, 2as is equal to what we are getting here? V square minus u square. So, finally, what is the equation we have? V square minus u square is equal to 2as we have. This is the third equation of motion. V square minus u square is equal to 2as we are getting. So, what are the three equations we have now? V is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, v square minus u square is equal to 2as. Just to derive the first equation, we are taking the acceleration definition, rate of change of velocity, dv by dt, and writing dv is equal to adt, integrating on both sides, we got v is equal to u plus at. To get the second equation, we are taking the velocity definition, rate of change of displacement, but the final velocity v is equal to u plus at, and just rearranging the terms, integrating on both sides, we get s is equal to ut plus half at square. What is the third one? To get the third one, a, again we are taking the acceleration, a is equal to dv by dt. Multiplying and dividing with ds and rearranging these terms, integrating on both sides, we got v square minus u square is equal to 2as. These three equations we have derived by using the calculus method. Okay, we have derived. What are the applications of these equations? There are two applications when the body is falling freely under gravity, when the body is projected vertically upwards. So what are the equations of motion that what we have to determine? If the body is falling freely, what is the acceleration due to gravity? It is actually 9.8 meter per second square. Suppose if the value is not given in sums, for simplicity, sometimes you can take even 10 meter per second square also. If the value is mentioned, you have to take that g value, 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, coming to the equation of motion for freely falling body. If the body is falling freely, what are the equations of motion? See, just observe this one. Say, this is the ground, this is the ground, and the body is falling freely from a certain height. Okay, you observe the body is moving in the gravitational field under the acceleration due to gravity. What is the acceleration? Acceleration A is equal to, say, it is written as G only. It is written as A is equal to G. Just say. Now, what are the equations of motion? V is equal to U plus AT. S is equal to UT plus half AT square. V square minus u square is equal to 2as. Here, if the body is falling freely, what is the initial velocity? The initial velocity u is equal to 0. What is the final velocity? It is v. What is the height of the object? The height of the object is h. Initially, the height of the object is h. See, so if the height of the object is h, what are the equations of motion we have to take? Just see, first equation, v is equal to u plus at, or v is equal to u plus gt. What is a? A is equal to g. What is the initial velocity? Initial velocity u is equal to 0. Therefore, what is the first equation? V is equal to gt only. What is the second equation? S is equal to ut plus half at square. But here, u is equal to 0, a is equal to g. Therefore, what is h? H is equal to half gt square only we get. What is the third equation? V square minus u square is equal to 2gh. Initial velocity u is 0, therefore v square is equal to 2gh. These are the equations of motion when the body is falling freely in the gravitational field or under gravity. Acceleration due to gravity if it is falling freely. So you have to take these equations. What is the state of the body we can understand by using these equations. Coming to the next one, see, if the body is projected vertically upwards, we have to determine the equations of motion of an object if it is projected vertically upwards from the ground. Suppose, say this is the height and it is the ground, say. Again, we are taking it is the ground. Now, if the initial velocity u, the body is projected. So, if it is projected with initial velocity u, so what we get? Say, if the initial velocity is u, after reaching to the maximum height h, what is the final velocity? Final velocity v is equal to 0 we get. Observe, what are the equations of motion? Once again, we have to remember one point here. What is the acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but acceleration due to gravity. But here, the acceleration of the body, it is in the upward direction. Observe, it is in the upward direction. Whereas, the acceleration due to gravity, it is in the downward direction. G, it is in the downward direction. Both are in the opposite directions. Therefore, what is A in terms of G? Minus G we have to take. So, first equation actually, V is equal to U plus AT. But what is A? Minus G. Therefore, minus GT we are writing. Second, S is equal to UT plus half AT square. So, what we are writing here? H is equal to UT minus half GT square. Why we are writing like this? See, here, A is nothing but minus G we are taking. What is the third equation? V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. What is A? Minus G. Therefore, V square minus U square is equal to minus 2GH. This is the motion of the body, or these are the equations of motion when the body is projected vertically upwards. These equations we have to use. Now, coming to the maximum height of the body. See, if the body is projected vertically upwards, what is the maximum height it reaches? That what we have to determine. What is the initial velocity in this one? The initial velocity is u. What is the final velocity? Final velocity v is equal to 0. What is the acceleration due to gravity? Minus g. All these things we know. So, what is the maximum height it is reaching? H. What is the equation we have? V square minus u square is equal to 2gh. But here one thing, g means minus g we have to take. So what is the final velocity? 0. 0 minus u square is equal to minus 2gh. Minus minus cancel, h is equal to u square by 2z. This is the final equation for the maximum height. Simply one thing, a body is projected vertically upwards with initial velocity u. Therefore, what is the maximum height it reaches? The maximum height, h is equal to u square by 2g. We have to take, so say h is equal to u square by 2g, we have to take this equation to solve the sums. Is it understood? See, if the body is projected vertically upwards, initial velocity u, final velocity v is equal to 0. Acceleration is minus g. The maximum height it is reaching is h. Now, deriving these equations, what is the equation or what is the expression for the maximum height? H is equal to u square by 2g. Next one, using these basic concepts, we have to solve some sums. Coming to the first one, what is the first sum let us take? A bullet is fired vertically up from the ground, reaches a maximum height 40 meters. Say a bullet is fired, the maximum height it is reaching 40 meters in its path from the ground, and it takes further 2 seconds to reach the same point during descent. The total time of flight. See, the total time of flight we have to take. Actually, what is the time of ascent? Time of descent. Time of ascent, u by z. Time of descent, again u by z. Time of flight, 2u by z. Simply, okay, I'll show something. A bullet is fired vertically up from the ground. Observe. See, say this is the ground. This is the ground. From ground, a bullet is fired. Suppose say, what is the initial velocity of that one? Initial velocity is u. So, from the ground, it reaches to a height 40 meters in its path from the ground. Suppose say, this is 40 meters, say. So, this is 40 meters. Now, after that, again it takes 2 more seconds to reach the same point. Observe here, from this point, it is going to certain height, again coming back. This is the maximum height. After coming to the same, to reach the same point, it is taking how much time? Total time for this one, t is equal to, say, 2 seconds it is taking. It is taking 2 seconds time. Okay, what is the total time of flight? It is asked there. So, after this, again it is coming to the ground, say. So, you have to apply the equations of motion for this case. So, what are the equations of motion? You write v square minus u square is equal to 2as. So, what is v square? What is the final velocity? What is the velocity to reach this height? V is equal to u plus at or u plus gt. See. So, what is the total time of flight? Time of flight, t is equal to, what we have to write? T is equal to 2u by g. It is the formula. 2u by g. Let us take. This is the formula for this one. U by g plus u by g, 2u by g. But one thing, what is initial velocity? Initial velocity is not given. Suppose to determine the initial velocity, if the final velocity is given, suppose here the velocity is v, that also actually we don't know, isn't it? So what is the equation here? V square minus u square is equal to 2as. We can write or 2gs. But one thing, to determine this v, you observe this portion. So here, what is the time of flight for this one given? 2 seconds given. That means the time of flight 2 seconds is equal to, it is equal to what we can write, 2 into v by, what is this one, g. We can write g here. You can write g. Therefore, 2 cancel, this 2 cancel. So you will get v is equal to g. So if v is equal to g is equal to 10 meter per second square, we know. So if the final velocity, here the velocity is known, how much we got here? V is equal to, we got 10 meter per second square. We got this one. Therefore, what is the initial velocity we can get here? V square minus u square. So v square minus u square is equal to, we get 2as. From that one, we get u value. So substitute that u, you will get u is equal to 30 meter per second, you will get. So 2 into 30, 60, by 10 you write, you will get t is equal to 6 seconds. What is the total time of flight? Simply, the problem is given like this. When the body or when the bullet is fired, it is going to certain height. Say at a certain height, say 40 meters. What is the velocity given? Velocity is not mentioned there. From that one, it is taking 2 more seconds to reach the same point. So from here, again it is coming to the same point. What is the time of flight we have to calculate? What is the total time of flight? 2u by z. What is the initial velocity? Not given. To determine this one, first we need this small v, final velocity. To determine that v, you take time of flight is equal to 2v by g, you will get v value. So v is equal to 10, we got. Substitute, take the equation, v square minus u square is equal to 2as. Automatically you will get time of flight 2u by g, that is equal to 6 seconds you will get. Okay, next. So with this one, let us stop doing this one. It is stuck. Okay, strength. In this way, we can solve the sums if they are asked based on the equations of motion. Anyhow, if some tough problems are also asked based on this one, we can also solve. In the actual classes, we discuss difficult problems or some more conceptual problems. Okay, good luck, all the best, bye.